depends on is based on this hadith from Abu Huraira Raziallahu, and this is the same message from RPN MDP president, which as Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated that the Messenger of Allah said, when a person dies, his deeds are cut off except for three: continuing charity, knowledge that others benefited from, and the righteous son who supplicates for him. So for years, pediatric trainees all across Pakistan have been searching for a comprehensive source of knowledge and guidance that would guide them towards excellence in the wide, demanding and fulfilling field of pediatrics. PNMDP was created in June 2020 under the dynamic leadership of founder Dr. Ayaz Ahmed. Our team consists of highly qualified members, comprising of people who have been through the challenging journey of residency and now making a mark in their specialties. So you people can even join us as a PNMDP member, and our aim is to improve mortality and morbidity. So as all of you know, that the founder of PNMDP team is Dr. Ayaz Ahmed. Board members include Dr. Adil Khalid and Dr. Rishad Ali Bajji. These are the members in 2019 and 20. These are the members from 2020 to 2021. And for videos on clinical and theory topics of pediatrics, you people can watch our YouTube channel. So today is the second last session of the October, and these were the sessions in the October, and you can join us as a member. Requirements are FCPS passed, happy to work voluntarily at least half to 1 hour in a week, enthusiastic and believe in teamwork. Selection will be after completing registration from form and PNMDP board or discussions. For this, you can contact at our Gmail ID. So our website is in the final stages of development. This is the look for our website. So you can contribute for our website as well. If you have some interesting case or anything, any for our blog sessions, common cases with atypical presentations, any pictures, any findings, you guys can just email us. And you people can even join us as PNMDP regional trainee representative. Send your CVs first of all, download this form and then send your CVs at our email ID. In a nutshell, PNMDP is for promoting quality education in child health. So today's session is about short case approach to floppy infant by Dr. Meher Afroz. As I already told you, that she is post fellow hem oncology in Indus Hospital, Quetta. So thank you all of you. So I will just ask Dr. Meher to start the session, and here I will stop sharing. Thank you, everyone.
हेलो, अस्सलाम वालेकुम।
वालेकुम सलाम डॉक्टर महर।
कैन यू ऑल स्क्रीन?
यस मैम, वी कैन सी।
हाँ, Assalamu alaikum, all of the participants. I'm Dr. Meher Afroz, currently working as a fellow in the pediatric oncology department of Indus Hospital. And today we will be discussing a short case approach to a floppy infant. Now, the floppy infant syndrome is a well-recognized entity and refers when infant presents with hypotonia either at birth or early in the infantile period. The objectives of our today's session will be to tell you to how to describe the distinguishing features of hypotonia, and to differentiate between the central and peripheral causes of hypotonia, And after doing a comprehensive neurological examination, we should be able to reach to a differential diagnosis of hypotonia in infants and how to evaluate hypotonic infants. The important thing to consider is that every child, especially under 6 months, who is presenting to you with hypotonia, botulism should be suspected, especially if there is constipation, if the child is lethargic, or difficulty in feeding, then we should consider botulism as well. Now, first of all, defining the tone. Tone, as we all know, that tone is basically resistance of muscles to stretch, and the maintenance of the normal tone requires intact central and peripheral nervous system. Hypotonia is described as reduced resistance to passive range of movement, and weakness is defined in reduction in maximum power that can be generated. Important thing to consider here is that not all hypotonic infants have weakness. Whenever you are examining a child with hypotonia, you have to evaluate that whether the child is hypotonic weak or hypotonia without weakness. Okay, because not all hypotonic infants are weak. Hypotonic infants can have normal power as well. But all the weak infants, weak infants, they do have hypotonia. So a systemic approach to a floppy infant. It starts with a detailed history, presenting complaint. Usually, they present to you with the parents complain that the child is inactive or doesn't have active movement since birth. The child is floppy since birth or slips from the hand. They do have these complaints, or less movements of limbs, or less motor activity, and or difficult. They do present with difficulty in feeding, difficult sucking, weak cry, or recurrent respiratory tract infection. First of all, we have to start with a birth history, which should include a detailed antenatal, natal, and postnatal history. Quality of the fetal movement is very important, as decreased fetal movements are give you a clue towards the underlying congenital myopathies or muscular dystrophy. Breech presentation is usually associated with, they do have other causes, but they can give you a clue toward a neuromuscular disorder. The polyhydramnios is also present in myopathies. So a detailed history, a detailed birth history is very, very important. And documentation of the birth trauma or the history of any birth anoxia or hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy is important. Apgar scores, if they are documented at the time of birth, can give you a clue towards hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy at the time of birth. And family history is also very important, as there are infant can have congenital myotonia, which is an autosomal dominant disorder. Usually, the mothers, they do have congenital myotonia, or it can be transient neonatal myasthenia, which is a transient myasthenia, and the mother do have history of myasthenia, and there are other disorder of congenital muscular dystrophies or myopathies which have autosomal recessive pattern. So the family history is very, very important of the presence of hypotonia or any particular dystrophies or myopathies in other siblings as well. Developmental history should include complete developmental histories of all four domains, as hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy, you will find delayed developmental milestones in all four domains. Okay, now floppy infant presenting features. The child will present with hypotonia, abnormal postures, diminished resistance to passive movement, abnormal range of joint movements, or the child can present with delay in motor milestones as well. After taking a complete comprehensive history, there should be a comprehensive examination. First of all, general look of the patient, which should not take more than 30 seconds, and should include a complete head-to-toe examination. And then 180 degree manoeuvres to elicit the signs of hypotonia in an infant. And after doing the signs of hypotonia in infant, and you should perform a comprehensive neurological examination, a quick and comprehensive. It should include tone, reflexes, and power, because a comprehensive neurological examination will give you a clue towards the anatomical site of the lesion, whether it is central or whether it is peripheral. Now, a complete head-to-toe examination. Assessment of the dysmorphic features is important. Dysmorphic facies like almond shape eyes and are present in Prader-Willi syndrome, doll-like facies in storage disorder, down facies in trisomy 21, and white sutures and large fontanelle in case of Zellweger syndrome. And there is a characteristic myotonic features in case of congenital myotonia. They have a characteristic myotonic facies like tenting or inverted V-shaped upper lips and thin cheeks because of the thin temporalis. Anterior fontanelle is usually wide in hypothyroidism. Cataract is present in Lau syndrome, and there is drooping of eyelid in myasthenia. Fasciculations of tongue are give you a clue towards the underlying spinal muscular atrophy. Large tongue is present in storage disorders. High arch palate is present in neuromuscular disorders. Hypogonadism gives you a clue towards the underlying Prader-Willi syndrome. And undescendant testes also gives you a clue towards the weakness of gubernaculum. And limb examination, contractures, or arthrogryposis is seen in both neurogenic and myopathic disorders. Okay. Now, after doing a quick head-to-toe examination, the most important signs to evaluate a floppy infant is to perform the 180 degree maneuvers. And first of all, in supine position, if the child is floppy, you will observe that the child is in frog-like posture. The limbs, both the upper and lower limbs, are in abducted position, and there will be no active movements. So basically, this is how you, if the child is present with frog-like posture, then it gives you a clue towards the underlying hypotonia or floppy infant. And then you will perform a complete 180 degree maneuvers, which includes traction, vertical suspension, horizontal suspension, and the prone position. Traction. Mark head leg is present when the infant is pulled to sit. As you can see in this picture, and a 15-month-old boy who has developmental delay and hypotonia, when this child was pulled to sit, there was a mark head leg. The sign of hypotonia. And in vertical suspension, like when you will try to hold the child in under his underarms, so there will be a slipping sensation will be felt as the infant will slip through the shoulders when you will grasp him under the arms in an upright position. Normally the child or the infant, they do not slip because of their normal tone. But if the child is hypotonic, you won't be able to hold them. The child will slip through your arms when you try to hold them in vertical suspension. And after doing her vertical suspension on horizontal suspension, and the infant who have hypotonia, they won't be able to maintain their posture. So the upper limbs and lower limbs both will be hanging loosely. and an inverted U-shape posture will be evident if the child is placed prone on the examiner's arm. So these are the 180-degree maneuvers, and these are very important whenever you are given an short case approach to do examination of the child of hypotonia. So first, after doing a complete general physical or head-to-toe examination of 30 seconds, you will first do these 180-degree maneuvers. And after, because the infant will be lying loosely and floppy, and you aapko isi se clue mil jayega ki floppy infant ka short case aaya hai, theek hai? To aapko clue mil gaya, 30 seconds ka aapne quick examination kiya, phir aapne foran se 180 degree maneuvers kar liye. 180 degree maneuvers karte hi samjhein ki aapko examiner ko aap clue mil gaya ki aapne pick kar liya hai ki floppy infant hai, aapko isi ke maneuvers karne hai. Okay, फिर आपने इसके फ्लॉपी इन्फेंट के मैन्यूअल्स की यहाँ पे आपको सारे साइंस पिक हो गए, देन यू विल डू अ कम एज शॉर्ट केस है, यू डोंट हैव मच टाइम, तो आपने कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव न्यूरोलॉजिकल एग्जामिनेशन करनी है, नॉट डिटेल, जस्ट क्विक टोन पावर एंड रिफ्लेक्सेस. ओके, दिस इज अ साइंस ऑफ मायोटोनिया व्हिच इज यूजुअली प्रेजेंट्स इन द मदर्स ऑफ द इन्फेंट. इफ अगर ना इफ द मदर इज सिटिंग विद द चाइल्ड, तो ना मदर्स में आपको मायोटोनिया का साइन मिल सकता है. एंड which is when you ask the patient or the mother to squeeze the arm for several seconds, and then you will ask them to suddenly release the grasp, there will be a gap of several seconds before the full relaxation is achieved, which is a finding which is known as grip myotonia. Short case में usually आपको नहीं perform करना होगा, लेकिन अगर आप वैसे कोई examination है, आपका कोई पास कोई case आया है hospital में, if you are trying to exclude, तो आप mothers में ये sign up कर सकते हैं, आप elder older patient में ये sign कर सकते हैं congenital grip myotonia के लिए. ओके, 180 डिग्री के मैन्यूअल्स के बाद यू विल डू कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव न्यूरोलॉजिकल एग्जामिनेशन, टोन, रिफ्लेक्सेस एंड पावर. यहाँ पे आप डिफरेंशिएट करेंगे वेदर अपर मोटर न्यूरॉन साइंस हैं, लोअर मोटर न्यूरॉन साइंस हैं, टू रीच टूवर्ड्स द कॉज एंड द एनाटॉमिकल साइज साइट ऑफ द लीजन. Because whenever you are examining, there are two approaches, either to identify the neuroanatomical site of the lesion, whether it is central or whether it is peripheral, or we have to determine whether the hypotonia is accompanied with weakness or not. And if the hypotonia is accompanied with weakness, then the distribution of weakness is also important, because it will give you a clue towards myopathy or neuropathy. Usually proximal myopathy, which presents with unable to stand from sitting posture, or proximal weakness is presents in myopathic infant, or distal unable to hold things is present in neuropathic child. There can be associated atrophy of the muscle in cases of myopathies and neuropathies both. Now now the neuroanatomical lesion, after doing a central CNS examination, based on the CNS examination, we should be able to reach towards the site of the lesion, whether it is central or whether it is peripheral. Central causes of the hypotonia are brain malformation, perinatal asphyxia, chromosomal disorders, or inborn error of metabolism. And the signs which gives you a clue towards the central causes are, there will be brisk or normal tendon reflexes, like upper motor neuron signs is know sakte hain. Preserved neonatal reflexes is a feature of central hypotonia or abnormal brain function. If there are peripheral causes, it can be anterior horn cell, it can be a lesion to nerve, neuromuscular junction, or muscles. Anterior horn cells mein you will get a generalized weakness and absent deep tendon reflexes. There will be alert facies, paradoxical breathing pattern hoga, because of the weakness of intercostal muscles. Intercostal muscles are weak, but the diaphragm is intact, so a paradoxical pattern of breathing is present in anterior horn cells. And the most common cause is spinal muscular atrophy. Okay. And in case of neuropathies, there will be distal muscle weakness and wasting, decreased tendon reflexes is present, and power is also decreased in case of neuropathies. In case of neuromuscular junction like myasthenia gravis or botulism, The characteristic features are presence of ocular muscles and involvement of facial muscles with or without generalized weakness. Ptosis is usually there, and ocular weakness is usually there, and so it gives you a clue towards the neuromuscular junction weakness. In case of botulism, especially if the child is under 6 months of age, botulism should be suspected, especially if there is constipation, weak cry, difficult sucking, and botulism usually it is a progressive, and the paralysis is usually descending pattern. Now, muscular weakness may, the signs will be decreased tendon reflexes, fasciculations, joint contractures are usually present, and they gives you a clue towards underlying muscular atrophies. It can be congenital muscular dystrophies, myotonic dystrophies, or congenital and metabolic myopathies. The signs which gives you a clue towards the central nervous system examination, there will be history of global developmental delay, seizures, movement disorder, speech delay, or birth history. Unko birth anoxia ki, hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy ki history mil sakti hai, persistence fisting hai, ya phir aapke jo hai wo persisting primitive reflexes, they gives you a clue towards the central nervous system cause. Early use of one hand only, it is a very strong sign of central nervous system involvement. Dysmorphic facies, like the facies of any syndromes, and either Down, Zellweger, and involvement of other organs like hepatosplenomegaly, and pseudobulbar paralysis, exaggerated deep tendon reflexes, or clonus, like upper signs of upper motor neuron illness is there, then the cause is central nervous system involvement. And the central causes that could result in a floppy infant are, we discuss hypotonic cerebral palsies, chromosomal disorders like Down's, Prader-Willi, genetic disorders like familial dysautonomia, and Love syndrome, in which cataract is also present, peri-oxysomal disorders like Zellweger syndrome, endocrine disorders like hypothyroidism and cerebral malformation, or inborn error of metabolism like gangliosidosis. Spinal causes are hypoxic injury to spinal cord and traction injury, and they both can result from a difficult delivery, or difficult delivery, or any traumatic delivery both. Causes of a peripheral pathology in a floppy infant. Now the causes depends upon the site: anterior horn cells, spinal muscular atrophies, or congenital poliomyelitis. They both are causes of anterior horn cell, which presents with areflexia. And in spinal muscular atrophy, there are characteristic alert facies, and paradoxical breathing pattern is there. And other causes can be radiculopathies like chronic inflammatory demyelinating polyneuropathies, and AIDP, especially when the onset was in utero. Neuropathies, hereditary motor sensory neuropathies, or hereditary sensory autoimmune neuropathies, or congenital hypomyelinating neuropathies. Neuropathies mein distal weakness hoti hai, aapke jo hai wo reflexes bhi aapke diminished hote hain, lower motor neuron signs aapko mil rahe hote hain. So basically they are neuropathies you should suspect if there is the distal involvement is more than the proximal involvement. Neuromuscular junction pathology, the causes of neuromuscular junction pathologies are botulism, transient neonatal myasthenia, congenital myasthenic syndromes, or magnesium or aminoglycoside toxicity, especially if any of these was given to mother during the antenatal period. Okay. Now the transient neonatal myasthenia and congenital myasthenic syndrome, the difference in both is that in transient neonatal myasthenia, there is history of myasthenia in mother, and it results due to the passage of anticholinesterase receptor and anti-acetylcholine receptor antibodies. from the mother through the placenta to the into the child. So the child will present with the features of myasthenia, like ocular weakness hogi, isme ptosis ka present karega, weakness hogi, floppy infant hoga. But this is a transient condition, and it is usually reversible and transient. While congenital myasthenic syndrome, you have it is because of channelopathies, and it is a static condition. Isme aapko mother mein history nahi milegi, and static condition, and usually patient does not go in remission. The difference between the both is this. Now coming toward the muscle disease. If the hypotonia is because of the muscle disease, then the causes can be congenital muscular dystrophies, myotonic muscle disease, like congenital myotonia. Isme aapko jo hai wo mother mein history milegi myotonia ki, inflammatory myopathies, metabolic myopathies, because of causes, and mitochondrial muscle disorders. Now, as we told you, the most important thing is that to reach towards the site of the lesion. It can be central nervous system, it can be anterior motor neuron, it can be because of the involvement of nerve, neuromuscular junction, and muscles. The causes we have discussed already. Now, this is a very important chart if you want to localize the disorder which presents with hypotonia. And first of all, we have to differentiate between central and peripheral causes. Usually, as I told you, that in central causes, the power is usually normal, okay, and or they can present with slight weakness. While in case of the peripheral causes, like anterior horn cell, peripheral nerve, neuromuscular, is decreased power. Deep tendon reflexes are normal to increase in case of central disorder, while they are decreased in peripheral causes, and they are absent in case of the spinal muscular atrophies. Babinski's sign is usually positive in central causes while absent in peripheral causes. Infantile reflexes are persistent if they are persistent, then gives you a clue towards central causes while they are absent in peripheral causes. Muscular fasciculations are a prominent features of anterior horn cell disease. And coming towards the muscle mass, muscle mass is usually normal in case of central causes. However, later in the course of disease, there will be atrophy because of the disused muscles. If disused atrophy is present, okay. In anterior horn cell muscle, there a classic feature is there is prominent atrophy of the proximal muscles, and in case of peripheral nerve disease, there is atrophy of the distal muscles. And in neuromuscular junctions like myasthenia, the muscle mass is usually normal, but it can be decreased. And in case of muscle weakness, there is proximal atrophy, or usually there is distal pseudo associated with distal pseudo hypertrophy. Sensations are decreased in case of peripheral nerve disease, while they are normal in other causes. Tone is decreased in all the cases. Later in the course of the central injury, usually they present with decreased tone, but because of the decreased atrophy, tone can be evolving to increase in case of central injury. But initially, in the infantile period, the child will present with hypotonia. Now, this is another picture showing towards the infant, which is a floppy infant but without weakness, and floppy infant with weakness. The signs of floppy infant without weakness is hyporeflexia and selective motor delay, normal head circumference, there is preserved social interaction, and there is a characteristic low pitch cry, fasciculation is present, and paradoxical chest wall movements are there. In case of floppy strong infants, there are signs of upper motor neuron illness, there is global developmental delay, microcephaly is usual there, and axial weakness is a significant feature of upper motor or a central cause. Now, after doing a complete neurological examination and making a differential diagnosis, our laboratory evaluation will be based on the our differential diagnosis, whether our differential diagnosis was central cause or a peripheral cause. Okay. In general, there is a rule that in case of all the infants who presents with hypotonia, sepsis should be ruled out first. So a complete CBC, ESR, CRP, and cultures should be sent. Electrolytes, calcium, magnesium can also should also be sent as other baseline investigations, and glucose, liver functions should be sent if there are any clue towards the underlying pathologies, or thyroid function test it should be sent in all infants or all neonates, especially if they present to you with hypotonia, to aapko thyroid must karwana chahiye, you know. Torch, if you are suspecting congenital CMV, especially if there is organomegaly and brain calcification is there, then you should send torch titer and urine CS for CMV. If you are suspecting inborn error of metabolism, then blood gases should be sent. If acidosis is present, then plasma amino acid and urine organic acids should be sent, and to diagnose the underlying amino acidopathies or organic acidemias. If you are suspecting any disorder of carbohydrate metabolism or mitochondrial disease, and serum lactate should be sent because they are increased in case in these cases. Pyruvate and ammonia should be sent for urea cycle defect. Acyl carnitine profile should be sent for organic acidemia, fatty oxidation disorder, and very long chain fatty acids should be sent in case of peroxisomal disorders. Yeah. Now, if you are strongly suspecting central hypotonia, then imaging studies can help you in defining the underlying etiologies, like structural malformation, neuronal migrational defect, and or in case of hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy, you can get cerebral atrophy, or abnormal signals in the basal ganglia are usually present in case of mitochondrial abnormality. Brain stem defect or abnormal signals in brain stem is present in Joubert syndrome. Deep white matter changes are present in Love syndrome, and abnormalities in corpus callosum are usually seen in associated with Smith-Lemli-Opitz syndrome. Now, if you are suspecting peripheral hypotonia, then creatinine kinase level will help you if there is muscular dystrophy. It is elevated in muscular dystrophy, but not in SMA. And electrophysiological studies like EMG and NCS will further help you to reaching towards whether it is a myopathic or neuropathic cause. Now, EMG itself is not EMG is not very specific because the findings are non-specific. So it just only gives you a clue towards muscle disease or myopathies or muscular dystrophies, but usually does not help you to reach a specific diagnosis, except in cases of myasthenia, in which a classical decremental response is seen in EMG, or in case of botulism, in which there is a brief duration and a small amplitude is seen in case of it is a characteristic EMG finding in case of botulism. Otherwise, EMG is not very helpful, but it can give you a clue. Okay, it's not usually diagnostic. However, EMG can also help you to differentiate between a neuropathic cause or a myopathic cause, and NCVs can give you a clue towards a neuropathic cause. And if the motor conduction studies are slow, then it can be because of underlying neuropathies. Muscle biopsy is usually performed to differentiate between myopathies from muscular dystrophies. However, most of the muscular dystrophies now usually diagnosed internationally on genetic studies. But if genetic studies are not available, so muscle biopsy will help you to diagnose both muscular dystrophies and myopathies. Molecular genetics help you to diagnose congenital myotonia. If there are CDG repeats are present, then it gives you a diagnosis towards congenital myotonia. The other features which gives you a clue towards congenital myotonia is autosomal dominant pattern of inheritance. There will be a family history, especially aapko mother mein history mil sakti hai, characteristic myotonic features in mother, presence of myotonic grip in mother, and history mein aapko uterine dystonia ki history mil sakti hai, and congenital myotonia mein aapko difficult labor ki history mil sakti hai, and early cataract surgery in mother. If these histories are present, it gives you a strong clue towards myotonia, then you should get the molecular genetic test CGG repeat done in those infants. SMN gene deletion, if you are suspecting spinal muscular atrophy, the signs I have already told you in detail. Aapko SMN spinal muscular atrophy ke bahut classical signs hote hain. Classical alert facies, bachcha bilkul active hota hai facies, uske paradoxical breathing pattern hota hai, reflexes absent hote hain. Agar if you are suspecting these SMA, then you should get SMN gene deletion test done. Toxin assay, botulism, you should strongly suspect in case, especially infantile period, especially if the child is under 6 months of age, difficult feet ke saath aa raha hai, constipation ki history hai, to aapko botulism ka test karana hai. Autoantibodies level, if you are suspecting underlying autoimmune causes of hypotonia in an infant. Now, this is the another important slide. Whenever an infant presents to you with hypotonia, okay, whenever an infant presents to you with hypotonia, first of all, now you have just a second. First of all, you have to differentiate whether you have to reach whether the sign there is central cause or peripheral cause. Agar central cause hai, to aap brain imaging studies karwayenge. If you are suspecting inborn error of metabolism, to phir aap uske test karwayenge. Septic screen sepsis should be ruled out in all the cases, aur CSF analysis aur karyotype karwayenge. Causes we have already discussed. Agar aap peripheral cause suspect kar rahe hain, if there is weakness, alert look, fasciculations, absent or reduced tendon reflexes, then first of all, you will check whether muscle weakness is present in mother or not. Agar muscle weakness mother mein hai, to do causes ho sakte hain, either myotonic dystrophy or transient myasthenia. Theek hai? So phir, agar if you are getting sign of maternal myotonia in the mother, then obviously this is a case of myotonic dystrophy. Agar maternal myotonia nahi hai, but there is history of myasthenia in mother, then it is transient myasthenia Graves syndrome. Okay. If there is no history of weakness of muscle weakness in mother, then you will get a creatinine kinase level done. If it is high, this confirms the case of congenital muscular dystrophies, which can later be confirmed by biopsy. And if this is normal, then you will get DNA testing for SMN gene. And if it out, if it comes out to be positive, then it is SMA. If it is negative, then you will get electrophysiological studies done, which gives you a clue toward underlying myopathic, neuropathic or neuromuscular transmission defect. ठीक है, अगर myopathic facies वो patterns हैं तो फिर it can be congenital myopathies, but which are later confirmed by muscle biopsy, because there are different types of congenital myopathies which can only be confirmed by muscle biopsies. If there are neuropathies, neuropathic pattern आपको मिल रहा है, then you will get NCV done. If there is, it is reduced, then it confirms by it confirms peripheral neuropathy like hyoidery, motor and sensory neuropathies. If it is normal, then it is a case of SMA. अगर neuromuscular transmission defect है, like आपको characteristic जो है वो decremental response मिल रहा है उसमें electrophysiological studies में, जो कि neuromuscular transmission का characteristic feature है, then it can be transient myasthenia syndrome or congenital myasthenia gravis syndrome. ठीक है, तो ये एक आपका पूरा एक कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव चार्ट है जो कि आपको क्ल्यू देता है कि हाउ टू अप्रोच टू अ चाइल्ड विद हाइपोटोनिया, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द बर्थ हिस्ट्री एग्जामिनेशन एंड लेटर ऑन टेस्टिंग थ्रू द टेस्टिंग. Now, how to treat an infant? Treatment must be tailored to the specific responsible condition. Usually, जो है वो underlying जो treatment है, आपको underlying cause को evaluate करना है, और जो underlying cause है उसी को treat करना है. जब तक till then जो है आपकी जो जितनी भी treatment है वो supportive होती है, because the infant presents to you with recurrent respiratory tract infection और feeding difficulties के साथ आते हैं, और so आपको जो है वो उसमें chest physiotherapy इम्पॉर्टेंट होती है, और रिहैबिलिटेशन विद द एड ऑफ फिजिकल एंड ऑक्यूपेशनल थेरेपी इम्पॉर्टेंट होती है, सो दैट जो आपकी जो डेली लिविंग एक्टिविटीज हैं, बिकॉज उस एज अकॉर्डिंग टू द चाइल्ड एज जो है वो हेल्प करें इन्फेंट को. ठीक है, और स्पेशली इन केस ऑफ अपर मोटर न्यूरॉन इलनेस फिजिकल थेरेपी इंपॉर्टेंट होती है, अगर फ्यूचर में कॉन्ट्रैक्चर्स को प्रिवेंट करने के लिए. न्यूट्रिशन इज ऑफ प्राइम इंपॉर्टेंस टू मेंटेन आइडियल बॉडी वेट. ठीक है, बिकॉज अगर जो है वो ज्यादा इंक्रीज बीएमआई होगा तो भी इट इज डिफिकल्ट फॉर दीज इन्फेंट और दीज चिल्ड्रेन, और अगर मैलनरिश्ड होंगे तो भी इनके लिए जो है वो न्यूट्रिशनली अगर मैलनरिश्ड होंगे तो भी आपको जो है वो रिकरेंट इन्फेक्शन के साथ प्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं, एस्पिरेशन के साथ प्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं. तो आपका जो आइडियल बॉडी वेट है उसकी मेंटेन करना बहुत ज़रूरी है, और इफ देर इज हिस्ट्री ऑफ डिफिकल्टी इन फीडिंग और रिकरेंट एस्पिरेशन लीडिंग टू रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक इन्फेक्शन, तो फिर फीडिंग और न्यूट्रिशन इज मेंटेन थ्रू नेसोगैस्ट्रिक रूट और पर्कुटेनियस गैस्ट्रोस्टोमी. Maximize muscle function and minimize secondary crippling anatomic difficult deformities like contracture formation. Regular orthopedic review for scoliosis and hip subluxation is an important aspect of management. Another important aspect of management is when it comes to give muscle relaxants in case of neuromuscular diseases, especially if it comes to give any anesthetics in case of neuromuscular disease, because of a chance or risk or to develop malignant hyperthermia. जब भी आप जो है वो patients होते हैं neuromuscular disease के, इनको आप anesthetic या muscle relaxant देते हैं, because of their prolonged effect there is a chance of malignant hyperthermia in these patients. Now, this is the end of the today's presentation. If there are any questions.
Thank you so much, Dr. Meher, for such an informative and great session today. So yes, there were some questions in the chat box that I would like to first ask you, and then one by one, every participant will unmute themselves. Someone asked that how to assess the power in infants and comatose infants.
अच्छा, देखो पावर इन्फेंट्स में जो है वो आप ऐसे ऐसे करते हैं, ऑब्वियसली जो इन्फेंट है वो आपकी जो है वो उसको जो आपकी जो कमांड है उसको फॉलो नहीं करेगा, देन बट दे आर सर्टेन वेज टू असिस्ट पावर इन इन्फेंट्स, लाइक कि आप जो है वो ट्रिकलिंग सेंसेशंस आप सोल पे ट्रिकल करेंगे बेबी को, तो ऑब्वियसली उसकी आपको ना पावर असिस्ट हो जाएगी कि जब द बेबी इज रेजिस्टिंग और द बेबी इज एक्टिवली मूविंग और नॉट, ठीक है, तो वो उसकी पावर जो है वो असिस्ट हो जाती है, और हैंड्स की पावर जो है वो आपको असिस्ट हो जाती है इफ बाय डिफरेंट सेंसेशन, आप ट्रिकलिंग सेंसेशंस करेंगे वो उसको विदड्रॉ करेगा, विदड्रॉ करेगा तो फिर आप उसको जो है विद रेजिस्टेंस के थ्रू भी चेक कर सकते हैं, विद अप्लाइंग रेजिस्टेंस एंड विदाउट रेजिस्टेंस, यू कैन चेक बोथ, ठीक है, और जो यूजुअली वो विदड्रॉ करता है आपके सेंसेशंस को तो वो अगेंस्ट द ग्रेविटी ही कर रहा होता है, तो अगेंस्ट द ग्रेविटी उसने मूव कर लिया तो कंफर्म्ड हो गई ये 3 पावर तो है उसकी, ठीक है, फिर 4 एंड 5 आप जो है वो रेजिस्टेंस अप्लाई करके देख सकते हैं। आई होप इट इज क्लियर।
And the second question someone asked is, ma'am, till what age do we have to do 180 degrees maneuver?
हेलो या
हेलो
180 डिग्री मैन्यूवर्स बेसिकली जो है वो आप इन्फेंटाइल एज में, और इफ अगर जो है वो फ्लॉपीनेस आपको मिल रही है 2 ईयर्स के एज में तो आप उसमें भी कर सकते हैं, ठीक है, और इन जो यूजुअली हाइपोटो जो आपके एग्जाम्स में आते हैं वो इन्फेंटाइल हाइपोटोनिया के आते हैं, इन्फेंटाइल हाइपोटोनिया के तो आप अप टू ना इन्फेंटाइल हाइपोटोनिया के आप 1 ईयर में करते हैं, लेकिन अगर आपको बहुत क्लासिकल फीचर्स मिल रहे हैं, इफ यू कैन परफॉर्म ऑल द टेस्ट इन अ 2 ईयर ओल्ड चाइल्ड देन ऑब्वियसली यू कैन, देर इज नो
सही
एनी
मैम।
अदर
एक और क्वेश्चन
क्वेश्चन।
है, ये चैट बॉक्स में आपको नजर आओ कि हाउ टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन हाइपोटोनिया एंड वीकनेस क्लिनिकली इन इन्फेंट्स।
हाइपोटोनिया एंड वीकनेस, देखो हाइपोटोनिया मीन्स के डिक्रीज टोन है, अदरवाइज पावर नॉर्मल, जैसे डाउन सिंड्रोम का अगर किसी ने बेबी एग्जामिन किया हो तो डाउन सिंड्रोम में आपको क्लिनिकली जो है वो मिल रहा होता है, आपको हाइपोटोनिया मिल रहा होता है, बट पावर इज नॉर्मल, जब आप पावर असेस करते हैं वो नॉर्मल होती है। सो एज इन केस ऑफ कंजनाइटल बिनाइन हाइपोटोनिया विच इज अ डायग्नोसिस ऑफ एक्सक्लूजन, अगर सारे आपको डायग्नोसिस एक्सक्लूड हो गए हैं तो एक और आप ना कंजनाइटल बेनाइन हाइपोटोनिया आप सस्पेक्ट करते हैं, उसमें भी आपको जो है वो पावर पावर जो है वो आपको नॉर्मल मिल रही होती है। हाउएवर जो है वो हाइपोटोनिक इन्फेंट्स होते हैं, ठीक है, जितने भी सेंट्रल कॉजेज के हैं लाइक क्रोमोसोमल डिसऑर्डर्स हैं यूजुअली उनमें जो है वो पावर आपको नॉर्मल मिल रही होती है, लेकिन हाइपोटोनिया होता है। सो एज आई टोल्ड यू इन द प्रेजेंटेशन दैट नॉट ऑल हाइपोटोनिक इन्फेंट्स आर वीक, सारे हाइपोटोनिक इन्फेंट्स जो हैं वो वीक नहीं होते, बट जो वीकनेस इज ऑलमोस्ट ऑलवेज एसोसिएटेड विद हाइपोटोनिया, तो जब भी हम हाइपोटोनिक इन्फेंट्स को एग्जामिन कर रहे होते हैं तो अवर फर्स्ट अप्रोच इज टू डायग्नोज और इवेल्युएट वेदर हाइपोटोनिया इज एसोसिएटेड विद वीकनेस और इट इज नॉट एसोसिएटेड विद वीकनेस, बिकॉज कॉजेज ऑफ बोथ आर डिफरेंट, ठीक है, सेंट्रल कॉजेज हैं अगर विदाउट वीकनेस है, पेरिफेरल कॉजेज हैं अगर विद वीकनेस है।
थैंक यू मैम। और एक और क्वेश्चन है कि अगर EMG नेगेटिव है तो फिर क्या हमें मसल बायोप्सी करनी है, तब जाना है मसल बायोप्सी के लिए या नहीं?
अच्छा EMG यूजुअली गिव्स यू अ क्ल्यू टूवर्ड्स, देखो EMG में आपको मिल जाता है अगर मायोपैथीज हैं, मस्कुलर डिस्ट्रोफीज है, अगर EMG आपको नेगेटिव मिल रही है, ठीक है, तो यूजुअली इट इट इना इट मस्कुलर वो आपको जो है वो उसमें मसल बायोप्सी की जरूरत नहीं होती, बट EMG इज ऑलमोस्ट ऑलवेज एबनॉर्मल इन केस ऑफ मायोपैथीज, ठीक है, बट द फाइंडिंग्स आर नॉन स्पेसिफिक, द फाइंडिंग्स आर नॉन स्पेसिफिक, आपको एक करंट क्लू नहीं देती, एग्जैक्ट क्लू नहीं देती, तो इसीलिए हम लोग ना मस्कुलर वो करवाते हैं, बायोप्सीज करवाते हैं, अदरवाइज मस्कुलर डिस्ट्रोफीज के लिए जेनेटिक टेस्टिंग्स आर अवेलेबल, मायोटोनिया के लिए जेनेटिक टेस्टिंग्स आर अवेलेबल इफ यू आर स्ट्रांगली सस्पेक्टिंग दीज।
सही, थैंक यू मैम। और किसी ने कहा था कि मैम अगर आप इसको एज अ शॉर्ट केस समराइज कर सकती हैं।
शॉर्ट केस, अच्छा शॉर्ट केस में देखो आपने हिस्ट्री, मैंने तो आपको बताया था हिस्ट्री से बताया था, ठीक है, शॉर्ट केस में आपको हिस्ट्री नहीं लेनी बिल्कुल भी, क्योंकि यू आर नॉट अलाउड, आपको जो शॉर्ट केस में जस्ट आप क्विक यू यू डोंट यू हैव ओनली 5 मिनट्स. आप सिर्फ जाएंगे 30 सेकेंड्स का क्विक इवेल्यूएशन करेंगे. एक 30 सेकेंड्स का क्विक इवेल्यूएशन आपको जो है वो इफ़ यू हैव प्रीवियसली एग्जामिन द इन्फेंट विद हाइपोटोनिया तो आपको क्ल्यू दे देगा. लाइक डाउन का आपने पेशेंट देखा है या आपने जो है वो बर्थ एस्फिक्सिया का पेशेंट देखा हुआ है और आपने जो है वो SMA का पेशेंट देखा हुआ है तो आपको एक क्ल्यू उसी वक्त ही बता देता है. क्योंकि आपको ये नहीं बताते एग्जाम में कि फ्लॉपी इन्फेंट है, ये आपको कभी भी क्ल्यू नहीं मिलता. बस आपको ये आपको कमांड देते हैं टू डू न्यूरोलॉजिकल एग्जामिनेशन. ठीक है, न्यूरोलॉजिकल एग्जामिनेशन में इफ यू आर सस्पेक्टिंग फ्लॉपी और हाइपोटोनिया जो आपको एविडेंट हो जाता है तो फिर आपने 180 डिग्री मैन्यूवर्स करने हैं. अच्छा, फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर आपने पहले क्लू पहले आपने नहीं पिक किया, आपने उसको पहले आपने जल्दी से उसकी जो है क्विक एग्जामिनेशन करी, फिर आपने CNS एग्जामिनेशन कर ली, बट आपको इसमें कमांड यू शुड हैव कमांड दैट यू शुड परफॉर्म CNS एग्जामिनेशन इन 2 मिनट्स. ठीक है, 2 मिनट्स में या 2.5 मिनट्स में आपने करनी है उसकी CNS एग्जामिनेशन. उसके बाद आपके पास एटलीस्ट 1 मिनट हो कि आप 180 डिग्री मैन्यूवर्स कर सकें. अगर आप बाद में भी कर ले तो देर इज नो हार्म. अगर आपने उसको बाद में आपने उसको हाइपोटोनिया पिक किया कि द चाइल्ड इज हाइपोटोनिक एंड तो फिर आपने 180 डिग्री मैन्यूवर्स दे शुड बी परफॉर्म. ठीक है, अगर आपने उसको पहले ही पिक कर लिया है लाइक एज इन केस ऑफ SMA बच्चा बिल्कुल फ्लॉपी होगा, फ्रॉग लेग पॉस्चर है उसका, तो आपको उस वक्त ही पिक हो गया तो आप पहले आप उसके एक क्विक एग्जामिनेशन करेंगे, क्विक जनरल एग्जामिनेशन 30 सेकेंड्स का, फिर आप 180 डिग्री के मैन्यूवर्स करेंगे, फिर उसके बाद अपना क्विक CNS एग्जामिनेशन, टोन, पावर, रिफ्लेक्सेस. और अगर आप जो है वो इफ यू हैव टाइम एंड इफ यू आर सस्पेक्टिंग HIE तो फिर आप उसकी जो है वो FOC इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट इन दैट केस. ठीक है, इसमें आपको कोई हिस्ट्री नहीं है, कोई कुछ नहीं है. मदर को आप देख लो कि मदर में बिना कोई साइंस तो नहीं है. अगर मदर में क्लासिकल साइंस है तो और वो आपने फिर पिक करने जरूरी है. ठीक है ना, बाज़ औक़ात ऐसा होता है कि आपको मदर को बिठाते हैं क्लू देने के लिए अगर मदर में साइंस है, एग्जामिनर्स ऐसे करते हैं.
थैंक यू,
होप इट्स क्लियर नाउ.
एंड आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू प्लीज फिल दिस सर्वे फॉर्म फॉर द फीडबैक फॉर द टुडे सेशन. और आई थिंक देयर आर नो मोर क्वेश्चंस.
ओके, थैंक यू सो मच.
Thank you so much, Dr. Mehr. Thank you so much, everyone.